The Member for Gippsland.
Thank you, Deputy Speaker. Just over a month ago, Australia commemorated National Landcare Week, recognising 20 years of outstanding service and practical environmental work across our nation. Landcare has enjoyed bipartisan support, and there are now more than 4,500 community landcare groups in operation. To mark Landcare Week, the Minister for Agriculture, Fisheries and Forestry distributed a media release to recognise the fact that more than 100,000 volunteers roll up their sleeves in communities each year to replant vegetation, repair erosion and improve agricultural production. There's no doubt then that the Minister knows in theory what Landcare does, but there's a great deal of concern throughout regional communities about whether the Minister actually understands how Landcare facilitates this great work and the importance of Landcare groups to the fabric of regional communities and whether Landcare will continue to prosper in the future. As much as members in this place lecture about the forecast impact of climate change, they should always remember the people who are on the ground actually getting their hands dirty to undertake the practical environmental work that helps to sustain our natural heritage. Our farmers, Deputy Speaker, are often vilified by those who have little understanding of the fact that it is the families on the land and in our regional towns who have adopted the Landcare message of sustainability and done the hard work that is required to enhance their properties and the natural environment. Deputy Speaker, it's with this in mind that I move the motion before the House this evening. In recent months, my office has been contacted by dozens of Landcare volunteers and paid staff members who have believed this government has failed to understand the need to employ facilitators and coordinators who play a pivotal role in managing the volunteer programs, assisting community groups, providing professional advice and mobilising the volunteer effort. As I said at the outset, Deputy Speaker, Landcare has enjoyed bipartisan support throughout its history, but I'm deeply concerned by the correspondence that I've received and the meetings I've attended with my constituents. The Victorian Landcare Network shares my concerns about federal government cuts to funding for natural resource management under the Caring for Our Country business plan. The network wrote to the Minister in August this year, and I quote from that letter by Secretary Kevin Spence, "We're concerned that under the business plan, Landcare coordinator positions and facilitator positions will no longer be funded by the Australian government unless they are linked to priority projects." The letter went on to highlight that there were 142 Landcare support staff working on the ground to support Landcare groups in Victoria during 2007-08. And according to information that I've received from regional areas, the number is likely to fall to less than 35 before the end of this year. Already there have been a substantial number of cuts to these positions made across Gippsland, with many people being made redundant across my electorate. And a senior catchment management authority executive in Victoria has also written to me and commented that whilst the Caring for Our Country business plan talks about the importance of land care and community capacity building, there's not one single dollar being allocated to the capacity, skills, knowledge and engagement targets. There's no doubt that facilitation of land care funded by the Australian government is dead, and whilst this may not mean the total destruction of land care, it will dramatically reduce the number of groups and participants. It concerns me, Deputy Speaker, that those views are being expressed by people in such senior roles within the catchment management organisations in Victoria. And those concerns are also expressed by Victorian Landcare Network. And I continue with the letter from Mr Spence. The VLN considers that the loss of Landcare support staff will have a critical effect on maintaining the long-term participation and engagement of the community in natural resource management. Our concerns are mirrored by the Landcare community, who question the rationale and economics of dissolving the goodwill, trust and experience built up over many years. Knowledge and networks will inevitably erode. Without coordinators and facilitators providing that level of support and communication, many Landcare groups would lose initiative, greatly reducing their capacity to participate effectively in natural resource management. Deputy Speaker, this is an issue, as I said at the outset, of significant concern right across the nation, and particularly in my electorate of Gippsland. On November 15, there will be an East Gippsland community rally in protest of the cuts to Landcare funding. Residents will gather at the Yorbos Snowy Rovers Football Club from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. and while it will be a community day with a free barbecue and fun for the family, it will be underpinned by a very serious message. The community is angry that this government is reducing its commitment to Landcare, and it's a story that's being played out on a national scale. The National Landcare Network distributed a media release on July 7th this year, and I quote again, this time from the spokesman David Walker, who said that of the $403 million in funding announced by the federal government, just $1.4 million, or 0.3%, had gone to community Landcare. And I quote from Mr Walker, "Landcare has a proven track record in producing best practice environmental outcomes and in growing and maintaining important social and community networks. The strength of Landcare is its local focus and character. Minister Burke and Garrett must ensure that grassroots Landcare has a place within their Caring for Our Country program." Deputy Speaker, regional Australians are proud of their contribution to sustainable environmental management through Landcare over the past 20 years. It's a remarkable organisation that must never be taken for granted by anyone in this place. Without ongoing funding to support the role played by the facilitators and the coordinators and Landcare volunteers themselves, the Landcare organisation will become a shadow of its former self and I doubt that we'll be here in 20 years' time commemorating the great achievements of the Landcare volunteers across our nation.